Well, welcome back to Scouting for History, a special Halloween episode. No, I'm not detecting here. I'm detecting over there. And the first find of the day. Not sure what it was. On to the next. Well, I was invited to come out to the school, teach kids what I do, show them how a detector works, show them some of the things I've found. And then they played with my Simplex for a while. They had a ball, about an hour and a half, finding pennies and trash and nails and things like that. But then once they were done, I had about an hour to poke around, do some detecting. Now, this is a Quaker Meeting House, and Quaker Meeting Houses have these burial grounds as part of the property. Now, a cemetery is a really old word. A cemetery is from the Greek. It means resting place or sleeping place. Now, a graveyard is like a cemetery, or it is a cemetery, but it's attached to a church. Now, Quakers don't have churches, they have meeting houses. And every meeting house would have an area where they would bury people, members, non-members, whatever. The tricky thing with these burial grounds is they would bury people, and then when it was full, they'd add more dirt and they'd just keep on burying people. So this has been added to over the years. This Quaker Meeting House was built in 1710, but this is probably a good 6 feet higher. This mound here is a good 6 feet higher than original. So tough finding some stuff, but well, we'll see. On we go. Let's have some fun. Well, I thought it was a piece of scrap metal, but it's a tiny little dog. It's a Scotty. Outstanding. Awesome. On to the next. Well, finally something with some age to it. I believe it's a button. Looks like it's got a design on it. I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. Thought it might be a nickel. It was ringing up low like a nickel. We'll see. On to the next. Well, the first old thing of the day. Took a long time. Wow, cleans up nice. It's an Indian. And I'll clean that up. You'll see it right here. On to the next. Well, I think I have a bucket lister here. Nope. I thought I had a croto bell. No, what I have here is a bocce ball. It's got an iron core. Helps it roll. Disappointing. On to the next. And now, a tiny metal button. Four-hole button. I'll clean it up, see if I get anything off of it. On to the next. Well, in a place like this, you really ought to dig everything. I was getting a horrible signal down here, very scratchy, very bouncy. I thought it was a piece of scrap, but I'm not sure. I'll clean that up. Very interesting. I'm not sure. On to the next. And if you're ever at an old house and you see these stairs to nowhere, this is how they used to get on the horses down here by the road. The horse, you would pull the horse up, you'd step up, and then you step onto the horse. Made it a lot easier. And now, a nice big old rifle car casing. Awesome. On to the next. Now the oldest headstones that you see here in the cemetery, or in the burial ground, are from the late 1800s. They have some more modern ones here too. There's none before the mid 1800s. And there's two reasons for that. One is because they kept adding dirt, they didn't have headstones. The headstones would just get buried. The other thing is the Quakers felt that headstones were snooty or pretentious. It was a sign of vanity to have a stone at your grave. So when they finally started allowing headstones in the late 1800s, they were very simple, basic headstones like these. So there you have it. On to the next. Well, finally, some old stuff way down deep here. Broken, but it looks like a beautiful old bridal rosette. I'll clean that up. You'll see it right here. Outstanding. On to the next. Well, that's it for this spooky adventure. Not a whole lot, but it was fun to get out, and boy, it was fun teaching the kids how to metal design. They had a blast. So, well, don't forget, hit like and subscribe. We'll see you on the next one.